Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching for today. This is Oneplus Nord 5 running with OxygenOS 15 v603 version. We already did the review of this update few days back along with its battery and performance test. You'll find the links of those videos in the description. But yesterday Oneplus rolled out the new update v604 for this device via OTA. This update is of just 24 MB in the size and its change log is very small. Still, I did the thorough review of this update via this video. In today's video, we'll check out what's new is in this update, its performance test in comparison with the old v603 version, and at the last we discussed do we need to upgrade or not. Before proceeding, small request for all of you is that please press like and hype button for this video, which will help to boost the views and encourages me to bring regular content for all of you. Now without further delay, let's get started. This update is just related to the fix for small camera issue that we will discuss soon. After updating to this version, only software version is changed to OxygenOS 15 v604. SOTA version is same, it's v120p02, except that all other things remain same, like Android version is 15 and security patches are of November 2025. This update is just rolled out to fix the issue related to third-party camera bug. Some users reported that they are facing issues while using Oneplus camera application in third-party apps. Now it's resolved. I tested camera in the dozens of different applications and it's working fine in all of those. Last time in v602 build, Nord 5 users were facing selfie camera bug, which was already fixed with small incremental fix and new v603 version. But there was some delay of switching between main and selfie camera I was facing in old v603. But it's now completely resolved with this new update. Next, I did the performance test of this version and compared its results with old v603 version. You will find the performance test results of the old 603 in the video. Its link is given in the i-card. Here in the Geekbench test, results of old v603 test were done on the 3rd of November, while new 604 test were done on 17th of November 2025 with balance and performance mode respectively. Old V603 with balance mode had the score of 1895 and 4408, while new 604 got the score of 1899 and 4558 for single and multi-core CPU tests respectively. With performance mode, old V603 had the score of 1857 and 4632, while new V604 got the score of 1936 and 4781 for single and multi-core CPU tests respectively. For GPU graphics test on the OpenGL graphics API with balance mode, old V603 had the score of 9482 and new V604 got the score of 9478. Similarly, for Hurricane graphics API test, old V603 had the score of 10,357 while new V604 got the score of 10,206. With performance mode for OpenGL graphics API, old V603 had the score of 9472 and new V604 got the score of 9442. For Hurricane graphics API test, old V603 had the score of 10,357 while new V604 had the score of 10,026. After comparing these Geekbench scores, you will find that new V604 had better CPU scores for CPU test results, while GPU graphics test scores were nearly same for both old and new versions. Next, I did the Antutu benchmark test and here are the results with balance mode. New V604 got the score of 14,18,203, which is drastically downgraded by 21,853 points as compared to old V603, which had the score of 14,34,656. CPU temperature during this test was rose from 35 to 44 degrees Celsius. Total 8.3% temperature rise was happened during this test. Next, I cooled down the device to normal room temperature and then did the Antutu benchmark test with performance mode. and I got the score of 14,11,252 points. Here again, the use downgrades of 38,501 points for performance test results was noticed as compared to old V603, which had the score of 14,50,653 points. Remember, I reconfirmed these scores by repeating Antutu test, but I got nearly same scores every time. Temperature during this test rose from 35 to 46 degrees Celsius. Total 11% temperature rise was happened during performance mode test. I think CPU throttle is more in new V604 version, which may be the main reason of this huge downgrade. And similar things were happened for old V602, which OnePlus resolved in V603 update. So I request OnePlus should look into these points and to fix this in upcoming updates. As always, believes in the real-life performance of the device. Even after this intensive test, my device was running very smooth all the time. I didn't found any major slowdown or heavy lag during day-to-day uses of my Nord 5. I noticed a minor device hitting during some heavy tasks like gaming, video editing, etc. I will release the battery performance of this update after 2 to 3 days of uses of my device, and will release its screenshot and details via our Telegram channel and via community post, so stay tuned. This is all about for today, guys. Hope you liked our work. Then please do like and share this video, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming content related to OxygenOS and OnePlus. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye bye.